Good evening. The extraordinary details of a bikie's public execution at Perth Motorplex have been revealed for the first time. A court was told a former soldier was paid thousands to plan and carry out the murder of Rebels boss Nick Martin. The shooter was today spared life behind bars in return for giving evidence against the alleged mastermind.
He's one of WA's most notorious murderers, but to protect his identity, we can't reveal his face or tell you his name. The sniper who executed Rebels bikie chief Nick Martin in front of 2,000 onlookers last December. And today he avoided a life sentence, set to spend 20 years in a high security section of Casuarina prison.
My client is disappointed and he may consider appealing.
It's alleged rebel-turned-comanchero David Pye was the man who ordered the hit. The Supreme Court told he contacted the former soldier and offered $10,000 to carry out surveillance on Martin, then a further $150,000 to kill him.
It's destroyed our family. We're all still grieving. We've been grieving for a year.
Over several weeks, the soon-to-be sniper planned the shooting for December 12. He arrived at the motorplex at 4:30 that afternoon before leaving to put false plates on his car. The killer returned at 6:30 and watched as Nick Martin arrived with his family. An hour later, he left the motorplex again, this time dressing in camouflage and re-entering through a hole he'd earlier cut in the fence, crawling through bush and taking his position. Over the next 15 minutes, he carefully watched his target through a magnifying scope and then pulled the trigger. Prosecutor Justin Wally told the court the rebels chief was a sitting duck. The killing took one life and ruined many others. And for what? For $150,000, the shooter could have gotten a FIFO job and made that in less than a year.
My dad was a great man that was taken by a bunch of cowards. That's all they are, cowards. Nothing will ever bring my dad back.
The shooting sparked a mammoth manhunt and Task Force Ravello formed. They found footprints and security footage, and on February 24, the sniper became their key suspect. 2 days later, he returned to the home of David Pye, where prosecution told the court he was seen leaving with bags of cash, which he buried in bushland. Close to $250,000, they say, was made up of money from the first hit and more for a second planned murder of another bikie. The sniper's sentence was significantly reduced because he's agreed to give evidence against the man accused of ordering Nick Martin's hit. Justice Hall took the time to warn if he doesn't comply, he'll instead spend 30 years behind bars. The killer will be eligible for parole after serving 18 years. Steph Baumgartel for 10 News First.